Our volleyball weekly update from GoJacks.com. Dan Georgalas is with us, the head coach, and there is plenty to talk about from a weekend sweep of the University of North Dakota. I want to start with Friday because I find this really interesting. You swept UND 3-0, yet you had the exact same number of attacks. You hit the same percentage. It's hard to sweep a team when those numbers are as even as that. So tell me how this happened.
Yeah, you look at the box score and it's tough to put the puzzle pieces together there. We ultimately swept them, but I think we're all a little disappointed in how we played. We felt like there should have been greater separation, but credit to the coaches at North Dakota and the players that showed up, because they're very depleted because of injuries. They're running a system and a lineup with the healthy bodies that they have, and they did a fantastic job of challenging us. We only had 4 more kills on the same amount of attempts, and we weren't happy with the defensive performance we had. We still sided it out and hit our goals. We had the kill percentage goal that we set for ourselves. But the way in which we defended them lacked a little bit of intensity, and I think that made the game a lot closer than it should have been.
That's interesting you bring up defense, because on the next day, you win in 5. You're down 2-1. Then I thought in sets 4 and 5, you really played well defensively.
Yeah, really, really well. The first set, we came out and made a statement and really just set the tone, and we talked about that a lot coming off the first night. But then we kind of let off the gas, and sets 2 and 3, I don't know if it was maybe expecting to win easy or something like that. North Dakota did a great job of picking up the service pressure after we had won that first set by a good bit. That took us off of our rhythm and took us off of our side out efficiency. And then we were able to flip it one more time into the 4th and 5th. And we finished really strong and we asserted ourselves really well.
We can highlight a number of names because, again, it's different in each of the two contests. You look at what Blau and Jefferson do. They probably are your leaders on Friday. But then Burke, unbelievable, 27 kills on Saturday.
Yeah, Haley Blau had a really good kill percentage, about 9 kills on 18 swings on the first day. But then Crystal setting a career high in kills and attempts in the second match was just an awesome performance. I think she had 8 kills alone in the fourth set. So just some ridiculous statistics. It's tough to replicate that. You have to celebrate it when it happens. We're so happy for Crystal because she's an extremely hard worker. She's an extremely strong voice in terms of leadership in our gym. She deserves the accolades this weekend for sure.
And again, a good group of kids, including your seniors who had their final opportunities at Frost last week.
Yeah, Jada has been really clutch for us. She had the back-to-back aces in our upset win at Omaha. And then in the 5th set, things were really even. I want to say we were tied at 8-8 with UND, and we were able to create separation after that. But Jada Barnes again with some late game service heroics, and she went on a really big run that allowed us to create that 2-3 point lead and get that separation that provides a little comfort at the end of a set. So she had a great weekend and was integral to another win. And then Madison Faye kind of getting the start. And she had a double-double, 20 assists and 11 digs. So we're really, really happy for Madison, who everyone calls Tina. And just to send the seniors out on a win in Frost. And most importantly, it was a win. We were down 2-1. And it showed the resiliency of this group and their ability to battle back and really just assert themselves. And, the standard was we wanted to learn from the Omaha match. What did we learn is that, you can lose on senior night at home. And we tried to fail forward. We tried to learn from that and use it as an experience. And we kind of said, hey, we're not satisfied here. We're down 2-1. Let's do everything we can to win in 5.
Season will end this weekend in Tulsa against Oral Roberts, and where ORU played well early in the year, not playing its best volleyball right now. You feel like you're playing pretty well right now, but like we've talked about, anything can happen, so it's a big weekend to try to end on a positive note.
Yeah, this weekend is by no means an easy matchup. You watch the film and it's scary. Oral Roberts is scary talented. They've got a lot of high IQ players. You call them ballers, just players that can play the 6-row game and they feel super comfortable. They see the game well. They attack all areas of the court. They've got live arms, good athletes, big frames, strong blocking, good serve. I mean, really, really talented. This is by no means an easy matchup, but we're coming on coming off a little 3-match win streak, and we're celebrating that and doing a lot of things for the first time, getting those little milestones that we've been talking about all season. So we're excited to finish the season strong this weekend.